Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to look at Lesson 17, which looks at printing within our XenApp 6.5 environment. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com and you're able to follow me on Twitter at The Urban Penguin and on Facebook The Urban Penguin. If you're interested in the Citrix Access Gateway, the VPX edition, I've just published a book and this is available now online at packedpub.com or available at Barnes & Noble, Safari or Amazon, your preferred reseller. So in this presentation we're going to look at printing within a XenApp environment. Obviously this is a very contentious area and is going to cause you some issues, especially if we don't change the defaults within XenApp. So printing is not that far removed from client drive redirection. We're aware of when we go into a session we see our client drives, whereas the same thing, we're going to see our client printers. But we run the applications on the server. We're actually connecting through the ICA protocol, the remote drives and the remote printers. What we see as a local printer is actually remote to our session. The big thing though is that the print drivers for our client printers have to be loaded on the server. So the default behavior is that all client printers are connected. We load the native print drivers on the servers, and this of course could mean hundreds of drivers loading within our XenApp printing environment. With a few simple policies though, we can change all of this. So it doesn't take a lot of management, but we certainly need to start looking at instigating some policies. So we can look at perhaps only connecting the client's default printer. We can look at disabling loading of in-box drivers so we don't actually load the drivers on the servers. And we utilize the Citrix Universal Print Driver. And perhaps for some print drivers, we refuse to load them at all. Here we're not loading the XPS document writer because we don't really need it as we have one on the server. So that's what we're going to investigate in this video, show you with a few simple policies how we can improve XenApp printing in your client environment. So to start looking at printing in a XenApp environment, it is best to look at the default behavior first. So I'm on my client machine logged onto the web interface. I happen to be using the web interface as my client machine. And if we take a look at the local printers that we have defined on the client, so we've got the XPS document writer, the brother printer, an HP LaserJet. I've only got one obviously as a default printer, but the default behavior is we're going to connect all client printers. Connecting the client printers mean that they have to be local to the XenApp server, so the print drivers are going to load on the XenApp server. So firing up Notepad, of course this is now logging me onto my XenApp server, and if the print drivers aren't already loaded on the server, we are going to load the print drivers. I can see when I choose to print from my application, so File and Print. Remember, the application Notepad is running on the XenApp server, but I see my client printer, so from WI. I see two XPS writers, I've got one on the server and then the client one. So perhaps we're confusing things from a client perspective here. Probably they only have one printer and they just haven't deleted their old printers. But certainly from a server perspective, let's just log out now, so File and Exit. Certainly from a server perspective, we have a little bit of an issue. If I go through and refresh, we can see we no longer have a session up and running. But if I open up PowerShell, and let's add in the snap-in, so add PS snap-in Citrix star. And if we take a look at the print drivers we have, and we can say just for server XA1. So we can see we've got the color LaserJet to 800. We've got the brother, we've got the LaserJet 4100, as well as then the universal print drivers, the remote desktop print drivers, and its own version of the XPS document writer. So once a print driver loads on a server, it's going to remain. We can leave this up and running, but let's go back to my client. To prove the point that these drivers remain, let's go through and add in another printer. And we'll choose, let's say, the Gastetner. So we're adding in another defined local printer on our client machine. We're still not making it a default. And we'll log back into Notepad. And of course, if the default behavior is to connect all client printers, well, that's exactly what we're going to do. Connect all client printers. File, print. So we can see included in the print list now is the Gastetner. Let's jump out. We'll log off. Check back on my server. So even after my session has ended, when we look at the print drivers available on the server, took a little while for it to show, but let's clear the screen, go back up. We can now see the Gastetner print driver is loaded on the server. And it's this type of behavior that you can see. I'm demonstrating with a single client here. You might think I'm going to the extreme adding in the printers, but I'm guessing you're going to have more than one client. So we have to change this behavior. Perhaps the first thing and the easiest thing to consider is when I go through and have a look in App Center, we'll just set the policy as a local IMA policy. Going through to users, I'll work with the unfiltered policy. So just like our client drive redirection, there's actually no need to connect printers. So I can go down to printing. And client printer redirection, if we add this and then prohibited, then of course it's going to do precisely what it says on the tin. We prohibit client drive redirection and then go OK. If I check from my client now and connect, when I check the print options now, file and print, I've only got the printers that are defined to the server, not defined on the client machine. So this way I certainly resolved a lot of issue, but I can also imagine if people have to print from home, then this isn't necessarily a solution for everyone, but it's a consideration. If we look at modifying the policies a little bit and seeing how we can adjust it to work in a little less severe way, so if I go back and we'll remove the prohibition of printing to client printers and go back and edit it. My next rule to put in under client printers, auto create client printers and add, instead of auto create all client printers, perhaps auto create the client's default printer only. Chances are they're only printing to the one printer, So it kind of makes sense. So when we look at it from the process now, we've removed the prohibition, so we're allowing client printing, but we're only connecting the client's default printer. And of course, then when I look at it from a client perspective, firing up Notepad, and then file and print, I've got the brother printer, the XPS document writer coming from the server, but then I'm not seeing anything else. So already we're going to be a lot more healthy, but remember, all of those print drivers I've already loaded on the server, they still are going to be loaded on the server. So we want to be working on the early days of our XenApp farm to make sure we reduce as many drivers being loaded on the server as possible. But let's jump out of this and then just say, for instance, what if my default printer was the XPS document writer? So if I set this as default, now when we go into Notepad, the XPS document writer allows us to be able to print to a document a little bit like PDFs, but it just ships with Microsoft Windows 7. Of course, is on our XenApp servers because we're trying to make them behave a little bit like Windows 7. But of course, this is my default printer, so it's been mapped. So when I go file and print, I see both XPS document writers, the one from the server and the one then from the client. Technically, I only really need the one, because if I do want to use this document writer, I might as well use the one on the server. There's no need to have the one on the client. So from this point of view, we want to prohibit the driver Microsoft XPS document writer from loading, because if needs be, we can use the one on the server. It's not going to save any resources on the server, but it's going to make life a little bit more simple from a client point of view. So let's jump out of this, file and exit. So that's going to log me off. We look at how we would set this as a demonstration. So when we go through and edit my user policy, move through to the settings and printing, and then move down to drivers or printers under print driver mapping and compatibility. I'm going to add in a rule. So if we can say that the driver starts with Microsoft XPS star, we do not create. So we can set rules in here for the driver name, allowing it, not allowing it, only using with a universal driver, or replacing with a more generic driver. So we can go OK on this, and then OK. So we can see the two policies that we have now, the auto create and the print driver mappings. When we return to the client, so my default printer is still the XPS document writer. We are going to be connecting the default printer, but we deny connecting it if it's XPS document writer. So now I'm back to just having the one document writer from the server, and that's the only one I really need. So we've kind of resolved the system a little bit, but of course, if I go through now and create a new printer, run through, choose again some form of random stuff, so here Konica, set this then as my default. So of course, we know now when I go through and connect, We're going to connect the default printer. The default printer is going to be the Konica, and of course I'm going to have to load the Konica print driver on the server. Now file and print. So we're seeing the Konica from the client and the XPS document writer coming from the server. So if we cancel out of this, log out, return through to my server, check the printers, and we can see now we've got the Konica driver loaded, and loaded even after the session has ended. So we can see it's really important, with the amount of clients that potentially could be connecting, that we control the loading of inbox drivers, native drivers to 2008. So the way we're going to do this, if we take a look at our policy, so remember all of this is the default behavior. I haven't changed anything from the default behavior. If I edit my policy, jump through to settings, underneath drivers, automatic installation of inbox drivers, we disable. So we're now going to say, irrespective of the printer, if it's a local printer, we're going to connect it, but we're not going to use your driver. If the driver is available on the server, we are going to use it. We're just saying, don't install the driver. If the driver's then not available, it will revert to using the universal print driver. When I go through and look at the universal print driver usage, we use the universal driver only if the requested driver is going to be unavailable. So it will be unavailable if we're not loading it in our session on the XenApp server. So the only thing I have to change is the inbox driver. That will then stop the driver loading, and we'll then use the universal driver. Let's look from my client perspective again, and we'll add in a new printer. So we'll have a Kyocera. And I'll set this as the default printer. If we double check to see what's available, so when I go through and look in my printing preferences, when we go through and look at the paper quality, so we can see we've got cassette 1, cassette 2, cassette 3, 4, 5, so we can see what's available from a driver point of view. Problem is, using universal drivers is traditionally they've provided you a certain amount of printer options, but not necessarily the same as you have within your own native printer. The Citrix universal print driver has the ability to read the meta information from the print driver and make that available to users within their session. So now when I choose to print, we go file and print. I can see that I've got the Kyocera here. When we look at the preferences for this printer, I can see that it's the universal print driver. But when I look at local settings, we're reading the information from the client into our session that we're seeing here. So we're able to choose the same information that's available from the native client, although we haven't loaded the print driver onto our server. So now when I go file and exit, let's double check back onto my XenApp server, open up my PowerShell prompt, just clear the screen a little bit, check the print drivers, and we can see we've got the Konica driver there, but we're not looking then at the Kyocera driver that we've just loaded. So it was available in my session, but we're using the Citrix Universal print driver. The universal print driver can read the metadata from the client printer to present the same information, the same paper trays, and the same printing options. So now we're in a situation where we're able to provide the client the printers of their choice, but still be able to produce printing that they require. The final thing that we're going to look at is about network printing. We might then create printing policies for different locations, and we connect network print servers that represent resources on each local network. So if I just type ipconfig from here, we can see, well, we're on the 192.168.0.251, and my client's on that same network. If I look at creating a new client, so I'm unlikely to set it in my unfiltered policy, so I'm going to create a new Citrix user policy, and we might call it, let's say, London, and go through next. When we go to printing, we have these things called session printers, so I can add them in and I can make a printer available to this session. So I can go through and say, let's go through and search for printers on my domain controller. I can go to the settings and make sure that the default works for our environment. So let's say use A4. And then choose OK. We say we make it available based on the filter for the client IP address, and then we're going to allow this if we're on the 192.168.0.0/24 network, and then OK. Run through next, and then create. Make sure it's being read in the correct priority. So the unfiltered policy is going to apply first, and then the London. And in the London, we're going to then assign users with the shared printer on London. And presumably then I'd have another one for Manchester, another one for Birmingham, another one for Bristol or wherever. So rather than having to define, you know, 10 or 12 network printers on my XenApp servers, I don't define any. But users then are assigned the one local to the network that they connect on. We should be able to see this straight away when I go into my client, fire up Notepad now. So I'm still going to get my client printer. I'm still going to get printers defined locally on the server that I connect to. But in addition now to those printers, I should be able to see the printer from the network share. So we go file and print. So I'm seeing now the LaserJet on DC, the Kyocera from my client, as well as the local printer on the server. So this is especially useful for organizing the client printing based on their network address. So we've made a big leap forward here in ensuring that we're providing clients with the correct printers without over-resourcing our servers. The last thing, especially for things, let's say, like the network printers, we have to make sure those print drivers are available. If we jump back now, so it's much easier to control our network printer drivers rather than our client printers, and we might want to make sure then that each server has the correct printer. If I jump back onto XenApp Server 1, we were checking the availability before of printers on XenApp Server 1, on XenApp 1. But if I go through and query, let's say, what's available on XenApp 2, well, I happen to have the Brother and the LaserJet driver, but let's say we had a network printer that was the Konica. we don't have the Konica driver available on XA2. So what we're going to find that's happened is that the universal driver is used for the network printer. So we might not want that, so we can replicate the drivers. The information that we're reading about where the drivers are stored is in the farm database, but the drivers are installed on the servers. We can set up replication to existing servers and as new servers are joined to the farm. To do this, if we run XA auto replicated print driver, choose the driver name, and obviously we've got to spell this correctly, so Konica Minolta 360 PSP. Where's it going to come from? XA1. And then in here, this should be minus driver name. So we set this up for auto replication. This again is stored in the farm database. It will be replicated to all existing servers from XA1. And as we join new servers to the farm, they will automatically have the driver installed. Can take a few moments for it to get replicated or become replicated through to XA2. If I take a look at it at the moment, so again, let's just clear the screen. Up arrow key and check the drivers. Well, I can actually see now that it actually has replicated, and we saw before it had the Brother and the LaserJet, but not the Minolta. So again, we've got a very simple way of ensuring, once we've tested and authorized a driver for a server, of replicating it to all XenApp servers in the farm. Thank you very much. I hope you found this useful. And if we jump back in to check the settings that we have made. So our session printers can provide network printers to our users based on their IP address. And then looking at the unfiltered printer, we're looking at then auto-creating only the default printer, disabling inbox drivers, perhaps setting driver compatibility and mapping to disallow certain drivers, and the universal print driver usage. We could accept the default, but the default for this, as is it showing here, use universal printing only if the requested driver is unavailable. So through the demonstration, hopefully you've seen that it's relatively simple to provide a secure and ongoing environment for printing within XenApp. Thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you back soon.